Representing sort of technology, and I think the question of cost comes up often with the operating expenses of representing financing. Now, what do you think can be done to bring down the cost of these transactions, both from an OPEX perspective, from a credit perspective, and a whole host of things? But I'd like to hear your perspective.
So before I jump into exactly the question that you asked, some of the figures. Although SME is the largest employer for the country, 120 million, the access to the formal capital is only about 30%. When I say formal capital, that is typically by banks, financial institutions, NBFCs, or some of the co-credit lending institutions. Having said that, quite a bit has moved. So, as Madhav was saying, let's not look at only negative, but what is the beyond challenges, what is the positive that has started happening. So, what technology has done in the last couple of years is, now when we talk of the M and the S part of the MSME, data is actually a challenge. And as far as I understand, there are 6,000 different type of units which runs in SME. It's difficult to templatize that and make credit available for them. So what it means is, whatever best available, you need to look at that. So what, even as Perfios and some of us on the, I would say, fintech has done, is typically we do assessment basis, some of the social data that is available. Now when you talk of M bit, the social might not be strong. So then we look at the bank data or some bit of the tax data. And all of this is possible at a real-time assessment analytics. And give the data or provide the data to the any of the financing institution which would want to lend to this case. And probably most of us would know that today a lot has happened, at least after the not so popular demonetization. But actually, technologically we are moving at least on the right direction, I would say. All there are challenges, and those teething challenges will remain. And if those are fixed, I would see the what Vasant has said, that actually the cost, which is something very important, and which for any lender, and actually any small bank is yet to complete the complete credit life cycle. So we are at early stage to point out, okay, this is the right cost at which I have operated, because you don't know. But having said that, I feel what is happening today is technically the data is made available at a very low cost. Who is using technology for that? So there are two important factors here. One, who is compliant SME, one who is not compliant SME. That means there is a formal economy and an informal economy. Informal is very difficult to get all data technically, technologically. In the formal space, very much the technology can help in terms of technology. So some bit which Madhav was saying, although we work with his department as well, but we see sometimes challenges where the banking is made available in a matter of less than 60 seconds. But there are challenges where the banking itself is not available, where is the kacha book, and we should take into account for analyzing data from a credit perspective. The bank segment has to become compliant to finally make technology effective and the cost going down. Till the time that part of SME doesn't come into the compliant bit, I think that challenge will technology can do so much and can reach to a point where the formal and compliant SMEs.
Thank you. Surya, what would you, I mean, would you add to that? What is your perspective on the role of technology?
If you were to define the problem of basically the, we're talking about the informal enterprises with the kacha books, with the reference checks, with not much of quantitative data, as Russell said, reliance on qualitative data. Essentially, what you're trying to do is you are trying to, like any good banker, you're trying to assess the five C's of the great online store, the first three C's, which is your character, your capacity, and ideally, you'd like to have a collateral, right? So, if you were to, because the audience is mostly microfinance here, what the microfinance JLG model has done is it was able to collateralize.